Do you think Tua's injury should impact the college football playoff rankings?
Do I have to answer that question?
Yeah.
I could read it again if you want.
Because we know how I roll with Alabama. We know that.
You say it so soft these days.
I would have to say yes, it should. Just for preference. You know, everybody's got their preference. You know, there's certain rules and regulations, then there's your preference.
Right, right.
I have a preference. Listen, man, I don't want to see no scrubs in college football. I don't want to see a bunch of no names that I don't want to see. I apologize for my love. I am openly confessing to my discrimination on national television. With all due respect, I don't want to see Mac Jones playing for a national championship in a college football play. If there's no Tua there, well, excuse me. Now, mind you, in fairness to Mac Jones, he's identical completion percentage, 71.4%, same as Tua.
Yeah.
He's got 7 touchdowns and just 1 interception in the games that he's played.
Right.
But he's no Tua.
Right.
And as far as I'm concerned, considering the stature of Georgia, the stature of Clemson, the fact that LSU, and oh, by the way, as much as I love my man Nick Saban, the best, the bottom line is I think that was a shot at LSU that the LSU beat Alabama.
Right.
We don't want to hear this might be the best team you face. You already
ridiculous.
You already maybe face the best team already because they beat you,
right.
Okay? So the bottom line, I don't want to hear that, but I will say this. Ohio State to me is real.
Mm-hmm.
Real. Okay,
that's
Ohio
debate.
State,
that's up for debate, but
Ohio State, LSU,
yeah.
Clemson, Georgia. I'm sorry, if I got the chance to pick any of those dudes over Mac Jones led Alabama, I'm going to roll with those four. And Alabama's going to have to be on the outside looking in. I just don't want this ain't no Trevor Lawrence situation from last year. This is not that. Mac Jones? I'm sorry, no disrespect, but that's not what I want to see. I'm sorry.
But if Michigan beats Ohio State, something like that happens, I don't care who your quarterback is. Like, Alabama is beating the brakes off of teams they're supposed to.
Yeah.
Right.
They don't have the toughest schedule in the world, right?
Right.
Lost one game.
Yeah.
Listen, it was a home game. That's a bad loss to take, but it's to the number one school in the country.
Yeah.
Now.
And it felt like they were going to come back and win that game, and it took an heroic performance by LSU to win. That's as home losses go, it's about as good as you can have. The way they came back in that second half.
Yeah.
And now we got to see the way the season plays. It doesn't bother me who plays quarterback for the team. The results are the only thing I care about.
I'm with you. Injuries are part of the game. I don't think the selection committee can sit in the room and say, well, they don't have Tua. You know, you have to do that for every team that sustains an injury, especially to a significant player.
Yep.
You know, my man Nick Saban, I love Nick. I've known Nick since I was in high school and I was in Cleveland, Ohio. He was at Michigan State. He used to drive down and recruit me. But to sit there and say this is going to be the best team that we faced, not only did LSU beat Alabama, LSU beat Auburn, the team that they're about to play. So it lets you know. It's a tough conference, but they beat them. So don't say this is the best team.
Let's say Alabama beats the brakes off Auburn.
Yet to be seen, but you can't say this is a better team than the team that beat us at home and the team that beat the team we're about to play. That is the best team that you face, not the team you're about to play.
Of course.
So I think there's a little politicking for our guy Nick Saban. He wants to get into the top four. I get that. I understand that. Mac Jones was recruited there. He's not a walk-on. He's a guy who they think can play the position. That's why they recruited him and brought him to Alabama. And you still get Henry Ruggs. You got Jerry Jeudy. You got Devontae Smith. You got 5-star running back Najee Harris, who's actually an excellent receiver out the backfield, too. So he got a wealth
and
of talent around him.
And a defense that gave up over 40.
Yes,
and you needed the 40-plus in order to make
LSU
the game competitive.
About Adam, by the way.
Yeah, but you're playing against Bo Nix. This is a freshman quarterback. That's really not the concern. So, you know, I don't think you can take into consideration that.
Some things just make me sick.
Talk to me.
All right.
Agreeing with me. Agreeing with me. Go ahead. Say it.
And what makes me sick
is
as I sit here and listen to this conversation about Mac Jones, well, why the hell didn't he play when Tua was hurt then? if they recruited him and they brought him in and he's capable and you know Tua is suffering from a high ankle sprain, why in the hell is Tua playing then? And then if we gonna make an excuse about Alabama being injured with Tua, you know damn well they gonna make one with Mac Jones starting. So when we have a conversation about is Alabama one of the four best teams?
Yeah.
No, they not.
Right.
Because we talked about without Tua, would they even beat the conference champion from the Pac-12 when we was having the conversation with Oregon and Utah? And now everybody is saying, see this right here?
If they beat Auburn by 10 points and Ohio State beat
right
Michigan.
See this right here? Auburn lost three games this year.
Yep.
All right? Yeah. They lost three. They lost to LSU, they lost to Florida, and they lost to Oregon.
That's right.
Okay? So if Alabama goes in and beats them with a backup, are we giving Alabama more credit than we give those other teams for beating them? Is that that's what we live in? Because they've already tried to do it with Tua injury.
No, what I'm saying is if they beat them worse than LSU does, and then something else has to happen, I agree.
Right.
But if something else happens and they beat, like, who knows if they win that game or if it's going to be close or not. But if they win it by a good margin, yes, it's a measuring stick team because Auburn's played a lot of teams.
Well, first of all, a couple of things that I'd like to add. Number one. It's not a crime to say that you agree with your big little brother.
It's
all right. It's a crime. It's not a crime to say that you agree with me.
I agree.
I understand that. You just said, I agree with Stephen A. That's the only thing missing from your soliloquy. That's number one. Number two, okay, let's understand something here. Alabama doesn't have one of the top four teams in the nation. Right. Alabama has an elite top four offense in the nation. Mm-hmm. That's what they have.
Right.
If your defense was all that in the bag of chips and your offense is still what they are, that would be a different argument. But you talked about Tua having to play lights out just to make it respectable after the way LSU was giving it to you.
Yes.
So it matters to me from an optics perspective how you go down. Right. I'm not just talking about the final score. I'm talking about us actually watching the game, watching what's transpired, having me go on Twitter at halftime and go like this. Damn. They done messed up. Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.